Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, I'm going to show you how the template library works and how this is different to setting up templates within a team folder. So if we go to our home folder inside our Dashpivot account, so this section here, you'll notice that there's a section called the template library. And the template library is used to set up your information management system inside of Dashpivot. So this is the place where you can set up all the different form templates applicable across all of your projects and all of your sites. The templates that you set up here will be standardized across the whole company. So everything will be controlled and it ensures a high level of compliance. And the key difference between setting up your templates in the template library versus setting them up in any of these particular team folders is that in the template library, the templates that you set up there can be used across as many team folders as you'd like, whereas if you set them up in just one team folder, you can only use that template in that one folder. You couldn't then use that in other team folders, other projects, other sites with other clients, and this type of thing. So it's very useful for that, and as well, all of the data that's captured using the templates in your template library can then feed into your company analytics. So in other words, the data that feeds into your analytics section could come from any, if not all, of your team folders that you have set up within your account. And the last thing that's good about using the template library is that all of these company-wide templates can be managed in one place. They're not split across multiple team folders. It's all set up and managed in the one place. So just like if you were setting up a template within a team folder, if you want to add a new template, you just click this green button on the right-hand side and add that template in, either by building it from scratch or adding in a free one that we have in our public template library. Once you've added it in, and you can see here, this template library has quite a large number of templates. What you can do in the template library is set up different template tabs. We have a separate video on this, so I'd encourage you to check it out. But it's very simple to add new tabs here. And it's just a way of organizing the templates into different business functions. So you can see here we've got different tabs for the different areas, commercial, safety, quality, environment, and so on. And under the All tab, you'll notice that the templates are also grouped. And this really is just keeping everything nice and organized. Now, once you've got your templates into your template library and you've organized them using the template tabs, in order to get your team to start using these templates, you must deploy these templates out to the relevant team folders. It's not enough to just set up the templates within the template library. In order for them to get used, you need to deploy them out to the relevant team folders. So the way to do that is to just select the templates that you want to deploy. So I'll select these three templates here. As soon as we make a selection, we get this deploy button. There is an undeploy button as well if later we wanted to undeploy it. But assuming that we want to push these templates out to a set of team folders, we would click on the deploy button. And it's going to pull up a list of all of the projects and team folders that we have within our Dashpivot account across the whole company. So from here, we can just select the relevant team folders or the relevant projects and team folders within them that we want to deploy these templates out to. And once we've done that, we just click Save Changes, and those templates will be deployed and made readily available within those team folders for use. So that's the first way of deploying templates. There is another way, and it involves going to that team folder. So I'll show you that now. So we navigate to the relevant team folder, we go to the template section, and we can see the templates that we've just deployed. But if we forgot some, we can also add in some templates from our template library from this interface. So when we click Add Template, if there are templates inside your template library, you'll have an extra option here in the middle that says Use a Company Template. And so you can choose some templates here from your template library. So we click that option, and then it pulls up all of the templates that we saw a minute ago inside the template library. So all we'd need to do is make a selection, click Select, click Apply, and we'll add those additional templates into this team folder. Now, over time, once your team starts to use these templates and fill them out and create many forms, when you go back to the home folder and go back to your template library, if you click on any of the templates that you have set up, you'll actually get a master register of every form that has been filled out across all of your team folders, all in the one place. So let's click on this template here. And you can see it's populated our register with a row for each of the forms. It's got columns for each of the form fields. And we have some additional columns available to us at the company level. We've got a filter for the project, and we also have an option to filter by team, which we can also enable. And this is useful if we wanted to look at the specific forms from a particular project folder or a particular team folder without actually having to navigate to that particular team folder. So it makes it a bit easier to navigate around. And from here, we can apply some filters, we can bulk export if we need to, we can do all the things that we would normally do via the register view. So that's it. One last thing that I would say is that if you make any changes to the templates that you have set up in your template library, any of the changes that you make and save will automatically deploy across your entire workforce instantly. So if someone then goes to fill out one of your forms via the mobile app or the tablet app or on the computer, the latest changes will come through and they'll be using the latest version straight away. So there's no delay in actually distributing those changes. You don't even have to redeploy the templates. It just all happens in the background automatically. But keep in mind that any forms that had been created before that change was made will remain unaffected. And that's it. So that's how the template library works inside of Dashpivot. Whether you're a small organization or a large organization, we always recommend making use of the template library to standardize the way that you capture information across your whole company. If you get stuck, you can always speak to us via the live chat on the website. We also have some other articles and videos available via the tutorial section if you want to check out some other functionality and features that we have available. And as always, thanks for watching.